no-gi, grappling, and wrestling is all entirely the same. So, like in wrestling, you want to put the person on the floor, on the back, and you score, and that would be it for the fight. But in no-gi, you have to take into account submissions and also getting swept back and all those things. Now, the first thing I have to say here is I'm probably not going to be taking down the very best wrestlers. And it's never going to be, that's never my point. Look, the point of the problem is, you just stand there, please, look. A bit more backwards and a bit more lower. Yeah. The problem with wrestling, if you do gi, is if you come close and he gets my sleeve or my collar and he gets it, and keep your arms straight, yeah, tight, it's going to be very hard to shoot in this case. So that's why if you play gi, you have to shoot from a bigger distance. And that's always been a bit of a problem for me because distance is off. So for no gi, you can go a little bit closer as I need to get a good grip before they can pull guard. Now the other thing, in wrestling, my wrestling coach Visuel is a very good wrestling coach. In wrestling, I emphasize a lot on this, come close please, on grip fighting and not shooting too fast. Now the problem is if you do perfect wrestling and you do a lot of grip fighting, a lot of head grabs and all those things and a lot of setups, well, you're gonna maybe take one guy down, but the second or third fight, your opponents already saw that you're gonna be taking down people and they're gonna be more wary and gonna be pulling guard faster. So this means every time I come close and I grab my wrist and I sit down, that's it for my takedown game. Now, it's not necessarily a problem if your strategy is just to fight up. If you prefer to fight on top, no problem at all, because if I pull guard, then it have them work for you. But I prefer to start the game with 2 points ahead. So in this case, I always prefer to shoot from a little bit wider and not too much time in setups. Today I'm not gonna go over setup, I will do that later. Today I'm just gonna go over my double leg version, and in the coming weeks I will go to single leg when it fails, when it gets stuffed, and also setups. Now the first thing I wanna do, the preparation. Stand up please, Latif, here, right? And put your feet almost together, yeah? And then your left foot a little bit forward. Okay. So first of all, people can be with 2 feet forward, they can be left forward and right forward. If the left foot is forward, I always fight left leg forward. I can switch both, but it's really hard to shoot. So my base is always left foot forward when I fight wrestling. So if his left knee is forward, I'm gonna try to penetrate, see, and go for a double leg. Every single time Latif, for some reason, has this leg forward, see, and I don't really mind, it just becomes, see, I can do the exact same shoot, bump, it just becomes more of a single leg. And it can be outside, it can be inside. Today I'm gonna go, most people, when I fight, they lead with a single, the left leg forward. So in this case, look, I'm gonna start over with the double leg, very basic idea. So, Latif is standing in front of me. First thing I can never do when I'm shooting should be to put my head down, see, and go like this. Why is this? Because look, the vector of my motion goes into the floor. So that means if I go here, Latif push my foot to the floor, please, and walk backwards, I'm gonna face plant. Now, this was nice with a hand. Then I imagine I'm shooting, see, and Latif sprawls, bum, yeah, and then you get that stuck in a turtle, which, it's not always bad. I do sometimes shoot like that, because in some cases, if you go for a very good wrestler, it's more important not to be taken down. So I shoot first and make sure that I don't get taken down myself. But ideally, what you want to do is you want to make like 2 straight vectors. Diagonal is it's overall shorter, but it's a longer motion than 2 straight vectors. So what I want to do in the beginning is make it like a lunge. So I'm here, and I'm going to go straight down. See? So if Latif's arm would be up, he's touching my face here. See? If I go straight down, I'm already circumventing the arms. Now when I'm here and I go forward, I should not fall. My shoulder should never pass my knee line. So what I want to do from here is I want to go down, see? And now, see, I try to jump in with my chest close to his body. And my arms are never reaching, they just happen to be here. That's it. So again, and forward a little bit, come a bit closer, eh? Stop here. So I can maybe like annoy a bit, pushing his head, see? At some moment, it's too high, see? I go low, see? And I'm gonna dive forward. That's it, see? My head outside. For sure, never put your head this way, because if my body rotates to the right and my head rotates to the left, it's like getting like neck cranked. Okay, and from here, I want to exaggerate my grips, see? And close my elbows. And make sure my head is super tight. The closer I am, see, push my head please away a little bit. It's hard, right? Yeah. Now, should Latif walk a little bit backwards? My shoulder should never follow. Because here, well, you can still get away with a takedown, but even if Latif would fall at this point, fall down, please, Latif,
It's not entirely bad, but he will swing himself up and he can start threatening my back. And I can fight from there. It's definitely a big part of my game. Fight from failed takedowns, but it's a bit more dangerous. So now I'm gonna go over the ideal situation. Go again. One thing I don't do actually, look at this leg. Often in wrestling or in general, like Satan has been taught like this, I go down, see, and I push with this leg. And that is not wrong, for sure not. I know my wrestling coach does it, and I'm not gonna like be correcting his wrestling. But for me, what I tend to have when I do it myself, also when I'm teaching it, is if the leg stretches, you're more likely to lose balance by leaning your shoulders forward. See? And I never want to take someone down in a straight line. Because every time I do take someone down in a straight line here, I have to fight against the both hips, the both legs, pushing it forward. No, up. That's harder already. And even if it falls, fall please, bam, my face plant and I end up riding close guard. Now, not the biggest of disasters, you score 2 points, but not ideal. So now let's go about how do I fix this. I'm going to go in this angle actually for 1 second. So here, I go straight down and dive straight forward, bump chest against his body. And my arms, I kept closed the whole time. Once I'm here, never go around with both legs with your arms because Latif, open your both knees, please. See? More. Yeah. Even if Latif would fall down here, don't up yourself, but if he would fall, he got access to the omoplata. See? Or even can go for Kimura here. And my arms are generally weak. So I prefer to just exaggerate my grips, see, and then pull back. This arm over here, even, it's not too important to grab. More important here is to just keep your elbows closed and squeeze his knees together. See? And I close my elbows as well. Now, if you try to wriggle your leg free, please. It's hard, right?
Yeah.
My most important thing is not to keep his legs closed. That's also important, but more importantly here is open your knees, please. It should be hard for him to open his knees. Okay, so now once I'm in, I don't like to take people down in a straight line because I fall on a closed guard. I prefer to go either left or right. So come back, please. So the moment I enter, I go here, I catch, close my elbows, and look what this does. See, I drop my hip and I make it like I push his knees together. So this motion from being up, closing, and then a small twist, see, close his knees. Now, Latif can do 4 things. He can twist either left, see, or right, and he can stand up, yeah, and he can lean forward. And then he can put his weight forward backwards, but in general, weight backwards would be very bad for him. So let's assume he's gonna keep his weight forward. Now, depending on where Latif rotates, and what he does with his hip forward or backwards, see, decides my takedown. Most of the times, the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in, see, close, and I'm gonna make don't fall please, keep it in tension. Yeah, I'm gonna make a small twist, I rotate my body, my legs first, step. See, now I'm gonna use my arms to don't fall yet, keep a little bit of resistance. I'm gonna rotate Latif inside, see, this side. So now give in please, so I rotate, see, and I can squash it with my shoulder here. Let's go again from the other angle. So here, I'm gonna go down, and as I shoot, look, I just don't do this, it's too far, see? I wanna slide on the mat. So I don't recommend doing this on the street, but on like mats where it's like kind of slippery, it's much easier to do so. So I'm making my distance, I'm gonna go down, see? And I'll slide in, and I catch close. I keep a bit of tension on this, please, yeah. So from here, I'm gonna use the drop and the closing. See, look what happens to his legs. I'm here and I drop, see? And I break the structure of his legs. Look at my hands. I don't even keep grabbing. Now from here, keep a bit tight, yeah? Not too much, yeah? See here? So I'm gonna step my base first, my legs, and then my arms, my body's gonna rotate. I'm gonna try with my hand to lift his bottom leg. So this is the action I do with my left hand here. I rotate, see? And I take him down. I'm gonna keep my shoulder on his leg. What happens to prevent here is Latif taking his leg out. So here he opens his shoulder, okay. I still got a takedown, but it's gonna be hard to pass. So once I'm here, I prefer to tripod, see, and drive my shoulder in. If Latif looks away, I look away and I wait. I might go for the smash pass if it turns all the way through. Okay. Well, it will become like a dog fight or fighting for the back. Or if I'm here and Latif starts to try to open his leg in this case, see, and rotate to the center. See, I can use it to start passing on the other side. I'm not gonna go too much detail there, but just to have an idea. Now, come up, please, again. Now, so I drop, go in, see, slide in, catch, see, drop, and really close my elbows, try to get his both knees together.
Now, in the case I step and I rotate, see, this is very important to put my hand against his legs and put this pressure. See, so make sure you're lifting his foot from the floor. Now, often this will not work because Latif is smart, he rotates his knees to the other side. Exactly. And now, it creates a lot of distance between us. So what I'm going to do now I'm going to go to the other side and start walking around. Now, it depends also if Latif stands up or down. Let's say he leans forward a bit in the beginning. He's going to walk that. No, don't fall too soon. Step back. He's just going to go walking around, see, and keep driving over. Depends here. Very unexperienced people in takedowns will use at this point, well, sit down, see, and accept the takedown and protect the back. A better wrestler, or someone who's more experienced in wrestling defense, will stay here and gotta go over. Now for this part, I already showed the whole part of the standing back take. I will have the standing back take in any of the coming weeks. I already have this filmed, so we'll go over the back take from here as well. Let's go again. Sorry. Send the front, please. Yeah. So guard your distance, go in, cover the legs, twist, twist, twist. He falls. Great. Latif gets back up. Oh, sorry. Second one, go back up. Go back up. Yeah. So, second one, I go in, I twist, he rotates the other side, see? I'm gonna follow the rotation with his legs. Just make sure your head stays high. If he keeps his weight a bit more forward, don't fall, no, forward, stop. Yeah, here. I can start going up, keep my neck straight. If he leans forward with his shoulders, his base is lower. I'm gonna start walking around. There's generally no rush here. There's many variations. You can try to find difficulty, please. See? Yeah. I just keep driving. So try to stand up again. See? This is a very common scenario if the person knows how to defend. Now, next one, we're gonna talk about the leaning forward and backwards. So every time I get here, and Latif leans forward, see? Then you should not be trying, well, you can still do the previous ones, but in general it's easy to keep here, see? And start going up right away. This is very important because if I stay here, grab my both feet, please. See? The takedown will become a lot harder when I grab your feet. So I like to, in general, go up straight away. And now, it's a bit at my leisure. Now, you want to continue, I can still rotate both sides, but usually from here, once you're up, see, you can stop your behind, then you can step it up, grab his both knees, and put him like a baby on your leg, and gently take him down. The upside, I'll ride the side control and 2 points. Downside, you didn't get the pass, but still leading by 2 points. So let's go again. Let's do a few examples. So I'm here, gouging distance. Find it, please go. And this is riding to my favorite way of passing the Khabib. Well, as Khabib calls it, the Wim de Putter. No, it's a joke. So let's go again. So I got the distance. Make sure they don't grab you because then they can pull guard. Go down. Go in, step, twist, but if resist, I'm gonna go the other side. Don't fall, fight. In general, I need rotation to take him down. If you stay straight in the middle, stay straight, then it's hard. We can be patient. No takedown points yet, because his knees are up, but the fight is generally going good. Every time he rotates either side, freeze, I rotate the same side. Start putting shoulder press well to the other side. You can go here as well. So, a trick to learn is to put positional rolling in every phase of the game, or just keep doing it and figure it out by yourself. One more, go back in the middle, which I rarely use, but it still exists, is if I'm here, push your hip straight forward. Yeah, if it's straight up, more, like an upright sprawl. It becomes harder to take him down this way, but I keep driving forward, can hook my leg, see? And now it's like a knee bar. See, I'm just gonna push my hip through. Don't fall. I'm gonna use my upper body, see, and slowly start bringing him down. And then it can still work either left or right. So once again, let's fight a bit more. Give more examples. I go down and look at this slide. So I'm here, I have to slide in. See, the closer I am, the better. And my arms almost never reach. If I get a chance, when his legs get close, I do grab.
It is better. Just don't open your arms. Never do this. Don't open your elbows. Keep them tight. Fight. Go. Once I get my hands together and my elbows are close, the fight is pretty much over. Don't fall. Fight. Fight back. And that's it.
Here we go. As you can see, this leads into the videos I gave about the rocking chair. That's also part of it. So, I'm gonna catch my breath a bit. Next week we continue with some setups.